Today, we'll cover the Gymdesk billing dashboard and dive into all the features you can use to streamline your gym's payments, accounting, and more. When you click on the billing tab, you'll see your billing totals for the current month broken down by scheduled, paid, and overdue payments. You can adjust the date range on the top of the screen if you'd like to see billing information from a specific date range. On the right-hand side, you can see the last 12 months of billing for a quick overview of your revenue growth. Further down on the page, you'll see recent overdue payments, followed by recent payments. By clicking on the Payments tab, you'll see a history of every payment made in your account, separated into different payment status, including paid, scheduled, overdue, refunded, and more. You can search for a specific member by name, or use the filter button at the top to search for a specific payment by invoice number, transaction ID, specific date range, payment method, or by program. By clicking on the invoice button for a payment, you'll see all the details of the payment, including taxes, fees, whether a discount was applied, and the payment method. Additionally, you can resend a receipt to the member. You can also click Refund to refund any payment that's been processed back to its original form of payment. You can refund the full amount or issue partial refunds up to the full amount that was charged. If you click on Sales, you'll see a list of all the point of sale and online store transactions. The Direct tab shows point of sale transactions, and the Online shop shows sales taken through your website. You can search by member name here, or use the filter to find a specific payment by invoice number, transaction ID, date, payment method, payment status, or by product. On the Recurring Payments screen, you can see an overview of all the recurring payments in your account. These are separated into different statuses as well, including active, stopped, and canceled. Active payments are all of your currently active recurring payments. You can search here by name or filter by member status, recurrence, or payment type. On the Stop tab, you'll see members who have an active membership but who have had their billing stopped. This is not the same as an overdue or failed payment. This means that a member has had their recurring billing manually stopped, but that they continue to have an active membership with your gym. Canceled displays recurring payments that belong to canceled memberships and are currently inactive. On this screen, you can create a new recurring payment and customize all the details of the payment, including any discounts. On discounts, you can create customized discounts for memberships or products in your online store. You can make these discounts available on signup or create a customized discount code for gym promotions. When you create a discount that's available upon signup, gym members will see this discount as an option when they create their account. If you create a discount without a public redemption code, the discount will show up as an option when your staff adds a membership to someone's profile. You can also set a discount to expire, either by making it available for a limited number of uses or by setting an expiration date. On payment forms, you can create a branded webpage that allows members to donate to your gym. You can customize the form title, payment amount, the copy on the form, and the payment confirmation message. The accounting tab breaks down all the revenue coming in via payments and going out via refunds as individual transactions. At the top, you can see revenue totals broken down by base amount, taxes and fees, and refunds. You can adjust your accounting information by selecting a date range in the top right corner. To dive deeper, you can search for transactions or use the filter to view accounting data by program, membership, transaction type, and payment method. You can also export a customized filtered report as a CSV to use with any accounting software you use. On the top of the page, you can click on Product Revenue to go to your point of sale report. This report shows you your total product revenue with a breakdown of cost of goods and net profit. The price of the cost of goods can be entered for each item when you add that product to your store. Clicking on Member Balances allows you to view all the credits that have been issued to members. These balances can be issued individually from a member's profile page. The Growth tab shows you how your revenue is growing month over month, making it easier for you to do budgeting and financial projections for your gym. The end of the year projection is based on currently active recurring payments and your average monthly point of sale revenue. You can also see at a glance where your gym is growing by type of revenue. Below that, you'll see a month-over-month breakdown of how your revenue is changing between months, giving you quick insights into how growth is affecting your bottom line. The settings page allows you to fine-tune your Gymdesk billing and customize it to your needs. In the billing settings, you can select from over 135 currencies, set up failed payment settings, late fees, invoice numbers, and processing fees. Payment notifications is where you can set up reminders for members that their payment is due, or set up receipt, invoice, or failed payment emails. On payment schedule, you adjust the timing of payment processing in your Gymdesk account. If you prefer to have all your payments come out on a specific day of the month, you can set a default payment day for recurring payments. Members who sign up during the month will have their initial payment prorated accordingly, and then their first full payment will be on the day of the month you set as the default. You can also set when manual and invoice payments are due and set them as automatically paid. When this is turned on, it means that Gymdesk will mark manual and invoice payments as automatically paid on their due date. You can also choose to receive a daily payment report via email. This daily email will notify you of all the payments processed, overdue, and failed that day, allowing you to stay on top of your member billing. You can click on the daily payment report email to go directly to your Gymdesk account. If you need to include tax in your membership prices, you can adjust that in the tax settings section. You can add up to two tax fields and decide whether to include this tax as part of your total price of membership or products, or add it on top of the prices you've already set. On invoice and receipt customization, you can customize the information that appears on your gym's invoices. Finally, payment processor is where you set up your payment processing platform of choice, either Square, Authorize.net, Stripe, or GoCardless. Square allows you to quickly start processing payments without opening a merchant account. Gymdesk integrates with the Square terminal, allowing you to accept multiple payment methods in person, in addition to online payments. Friendly Payments is our preferred U.S. merchant account provider. They provide superior rates and next business day payments, and you can apply for Friendly Payments using our application on this page. Friendly Payments uses Authorize.net as the payment gateway, so if you have an existing Authorize.net account, you can connect that through this page. Stripe also allows you to process payments without opening a merchant account. In addition to card payments, they provide support for bank transfers and ACH payments in the US and other countries. Gymdesk integrates with Stripe's terminal if you want to have a physical card reader at your gym. If you don't want to take credit card payments, GoCardless may be a good option for your gym, as they provide direct bank deposits in many countries around the world. Until next time, keep growing.